The sun is setting and we're at Botanic as I shoot my final episode for season 3 on Danu on Fire. Thank you so very much for being with us, and a big shout out to our sponsors who have been on the show, LICC Jeans. Thanks for making it a reality. Now, as I close the season, I have someone very special. He is Colombo's favorite makeup personality. He has made people look phenomenal. Their big days are made special big days because of him. I'm happy to have BJP on the show. Danu on Fire, right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel, made possible by our friends at LICC Jeans. I got them ripped this time around. With me, I have someone who's so amazingly talented. My aunt's all-time favorite at any given time. He is Viran. He doesn't need any introduction in Colombo. BJP, all the way. You can contest for election and you might just win it.
Really? Will I? Okay. Good to know.
If you can make people look beautiful, I think they'll all vote for you.
Okay.
Yeah, because we are looking quite deep. Welcome to the show. How are you? Cheers to the final show of the season.
Cheers, then.
I have somehow survived. I have a drink. No, and cheers to good life. All right, just a brief of where we are. We're at Botanic. It's simply amazing. So stunning, the view is, and food is really good here. I've come here a few times. You come here often?
Yeah. I was like here last Sunday.
In the hood, he's in the hood. All right, let's start things off. How are you doing?
Very good.
Did you ever think that you'll be Colombo's most wanted makeup artist?
Am I? I don't know.
I'm of course categorize you as that.
I try to be good, so I don't know.
But it was a learning process, because I still remember when he was training, that's the time when I started to iron my hair, and you ironed my hair with a little pink iron.
I ironed your hair for the first time. I mean, that was your first time.
That was mine and yours too, I think. It was a little pink iron, do you remember that?
Yeah, I remember.
So how has it been, the journey up to date?
It's been really good, somewhat challenging, but I have enjoyed it all through, like throughout, so yeah, I'm very happy with where I am now.
Excellent. You know, something that I really like about Viran is the fact that he learned makeup on his own, and he also went to the best to learn it, and he brought the best products. Yeah. So that he always says, if you're going to ask a good price, give them the good things as well.
Yeah.
Because we did a WTF together.
Yeah.
I got the good stuff from me.
Yeah.
So tell me, what made you take such decisions?
I always wanted to do something like this. I knew that I had a desire for like something like this industry, but I studied something completely different.
Yeah, you're in banking.
Yeah, I was.
Oh,
in
you look terrible with a tie.
Yeah, I know. It felt wrong, so then I decided to leave and start this, and then I found out like I have a desire for makeup, so I've been a makeup artist since then.
Now, but you know, there are so many makeup artists today, you know. There are. Yeah. But you believe in using good products. What was the key reason behind it?
I think in terms of, like, in order to give a good end result, you need to use good products and good tools. But good products don't necessarily mean it has to be expensive.
Yeah.
But with experience, you tend to, like, find out what the good products are. So I was always like keen about, I wanted to find out what the good products are all the time.
You didn't get me that makeup remover, no? That you promised me you'll get that big bottle of water looking thing? No, right?
Which one was
now
it?
That I've just asked you on TV, I think it's high time.
No,
it was not small,
water.
It was this big.
Yeah, micellar water.
And?
I forgot, sorry. Next time.
Thanks. All right. So let's speak about growing up. How are you? You're very close to your sister.
Yeah, very much.
Yeah.
And my brothers, but I'm very close to my sister.
Okay, and she's in London.
Yes.
So that's the frequent.
That's why.
That's one of the reasons.
Often. And I have really good friends in London, like very close friends. So I go to see them as well.
Okay.
And I personally love London, everything about it.
So tell me about your growing up time. How were you with food? Are you a foodie?
I used to be, but when I was 19, someone called me fat, someone I really like cared about. So then I started being on a diet. So since then, I've not been like a big food lover.
One person called you fat?
Yeah, I mean, I was like, I was really stupid and young. So
then after that, you have just been this
now
size?
Now I enjoy it, but I limit my portions because I don't have time to
eat all the time.
I want
the same person to call me fat.
Sorry?
So many have called me fat and nothing seems to...
I think it happened for the best of reasons because I thought I was like really overweight then. So it helped me be in shape now. So I take everything in a very positive way.
But when you were growing up, like until you were 19, when you were just normal, how was it for you? Like what was your Sunday special?
Rice.
Rice and curry. Who cooks at home?
My sister.
Okay.
I used to love that. I used to love my
rice
sister's
and
cooking.
Like butt
rice,
and what?
Curry, beetroot, carrot, malung, anything.
Real Sri Lankan rice and curry.
There's chicken, nothing, fish.
Nothing to beat that, no?
Yeah.
At any given time.
Yeah.
Can you cook?
I can't.
Nothing? Not even to save your soul?
I can make scrambled egg.
That's good. That's protein.
Yeah.
So we were speaking to some of your friends about you were having some very busy nights in the past few days, right?
Yeah.
You have been having a good time?
Yeah.
Yeah. So as this is the season finale for this season, we thought we need to get somebody who is quite interesting. So we thought, Mira.
Yeah, I'm very interesting, okay?
Yeah. But you're very like limited in conversation, but what to do? So now, you have recently apparently fallen in love with German food.
Yes.
You have?
I have.
And how has it been? Because it's not the season for like German food. Like I have never come across anyone who likes German food in Sri Lanka as much as you have been enjoying in the last few days. How has it been?
I tend to like German food a lot more than usual now.
Is
I
it
recently.
Bangers and
it's
Mash?
Been,
Is that
it's been 2 months now.
Really?
Yeah. Yes.
Wow, that's amazing. Is it bangers and mash on the menu?
That's also included.
That's it?
Who told you this?
About your German interest. About the food that you like?
Yeah.
I have sources because this is the season finale. We have really taken the depth of it. But this is all about food. So let's speak more, of course.
Cool.
When we do come back after the break, do stick around. It's Done on Fire right here on High TV. We're shooting at Botanic. We'll see you on the other side with our main courses. It's Done on Fire, season finale for my third season. I'm with Viran, BJP, hashtag. And we are at Botanic, beautiful place. I love the interior. I've always loved the paintings on the wall. You have to come check it out if you have not. Sunset is so stunning from here. You look at the city life in the best possible way. Normally, it doesn't look so nice. Not from actually, birds have the best view. Have you ever thought of it?
Yeah. Of course.
Yeah.
I've always thought about it. I really want to be one.
Like they can stay away from it. They're like, oh, that smells. All right. So now you are a healthy eater, no? This is perfect. This is salad.
Not so much these days. When I'm busy with work, I can't stick to my healthy meal plan.
What's your like that thing that you really want? Like I want like soft. Is it soft cone ice cream? I don't know what you call it. The soft ice cream.
I love bread.
Yeah. I understand.
I love bread. I'm obsessed. Bread. And biscuits, cookies.
All right, great.
That's my weakness.
But that's always something. So now, although you eat, will you? Now we better eat and talk. No, we can't be just like trying to be all. Now tell me, in this industry, they expect you to be a drama queen, over the top, extremely made up always.
Yeah.
Why are you in mourning day? You're so different. You're so very subtle, so subtle in the way you talk.
Yeah, I think I became a makeup artist because I wanted to be a makeup artist, not because of anything else.
Not because you wanted to be a makeup artist.
No, because this is my passion, this is what I love doing.
Mm.
So I don't think about anything else beyond that. I don't think I have to look a certain way to become a makeup artist because I'm too focused.
Although you say you don't have a look, you do have a look.
Yeah. I mean, I try to be simple and plain and comfortable.
Yeah,
that's my style.
Have you ever messed up a bride's makeup? You know, sometimes...
No, so far, no, I haven't. Sorry. I'm not planning to.
Sorry that I have to ask the dramatic question. Yeah.
What?
Gold.
Touch gold.
No, tell me about... No, because, you know, sometimes clients can be very tricky. Like,
although
you feel that red lipstick is just going to take it from, like...
Yeah.
From ward place to Peta, they will still insist that the red makeup should come on.
Yeah.
How do you tackle that situation?
So, I definitely do a trial beforehand. Okay. So, that's when we talk about everything and we finalize the look. Sometimes I change it on the day of the wedding, but as far as the client is comfortable with it, I'm okay to do a lot of things, but I have to understand the client. I talk to her first, make her feel comfortable, that's her day, right?
Yeah.
It may be just another bride for me, but for her, it's a special day.
Hopefully, that's the only day.
Yeah.
That's another problem.
Sometimes there are a few, but...
Because that's why your career is very prosperous now.
Thank you. Yeah, I want to listen.
It's not once anymore.
I try to listen to the client and understand her and make her feel comfortable.
Now, most of the time I have seen grooms just getting some foundation done just before the wedding. They're like, "I don't know, do you do that?"
Yeah, I do. I don't really charge, so...
Yeah, because see, no. Because the other side, the oil is pouring and they just look like tragic, like a cat has dragged them in.
When you think about it, you don't have to do a lot with their makeup.
So now, although this is such a competitive field, how do you sort of stay away from the wang?
I just focus on my work and I go home after that.
And you don't even do hair?
No.
You don't do dressing, nothing. You just do makeup.
Yeah.
That's it. Do you feel like you should get into all of that one day?
No. I always wanted to be a makeup artist.
I want
to stick to what I can do best.
Okay. So, not touching sari.
Sometimes you need to help clients and friends so I can manage. But if you know things, I want to learn things, but I don't want to do it as a career.
Right, just because you want the knowledge, that's about it.
Yeah.
Brilliant, that's so much to you.
Yeah.
All right.
It's not a waste.
Yeah. So I told you, I'm not going to just keep you blank. I have real food for you. It was not a fake date.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. All right, main has arrived.
Thanks.
I'll move this up.
Yeah.
What did you get? Yours looks prettier. Thank you.
Yeah, actually, I like this dish.
Yeah. May that water drop now.
Yeah, chance.
All right. I don't know what... mine is a prawn.
This is that... moda.
Yeah, that looks nice. There's a crunch to it.
Mm.
I don't know.
I actually always have this dish.
Really?
Yeah.
See, we know you really well. All right. Now that we have spoken about family, let's speak about friends. You have created your own family in where you are right now. You have created a family for you, who you hang out with.
Thank you.
How did all of that happen? Now, some of these friends are not even in the trade, but you hang out with them always.
Mm.
And I've had a very...
A lot of friends that I have right now, I met them like after I became a makeup artist. Some of them through work, some of them like through other friends. Yeah. So,
but
yeah, pretty awesome.
Yeah, we get more food. What is that? Eggplant and...
That looks nice. I've never had it.
Wild
before.
Rice, and there's also a rocket leaf. Well, that looks really nice. Thank you. When I thought I can go healthy.
So I was saying, they are a big part of my life.
Yeah. But you are soft-spoken. Always you just need a few things.
You've known.
You just need a few things to... I should have just got you for another show. If I'm getting you for another show, I know what to do.
What?
There's a secret cocktail that I haven't given before. This is just too normal.
What
you're just too...
Yeah. I'm loud when I'm...
Yeah.
You know that.
I know, I can't say that, but it's fine. Now we have said it. Let's beep it. Let's get into a break. We'll see you on the other side.
Oh, I can say it.
Anyway, you said it. No. There's something called beep for that.
Okay.
We'll see you after the break. This is Done on Fire. Final segment right here on Done on Fire. We are at Botanic, and this is my favorite part of it, dessert. What are you having?
Some sago.
Yours look healthy. Mine is a dark chocolate nut pie. Okay, I'll share
first,
with you.
Yeah.
Let's put it that way. All right, so what would you say was the highlight of your career, apart from being on this show and doing my makeup one day?
Yeah, apart from that, I
those
think
two
yeah.
top rated
yeah
priorities.
Second most important
third
first
two
is being able to be a part of London Fashion Week.
Wow.
2 years ago. You knew that, no?
No.
Yeah, in 2017.
Really?
I was picked up by a big huge makeup artist.
Don't say picked up. More like headhunted.
Okay. Yeah, I mean on social
picked
media.
Up and you don't get
yeah, unfortunately. Okay. So, yeah. So
and
she asked me to
come
and...
how was it working with London Fashion Week?
It was amazing. It was one of the best experiences in my life.
Okay.
Because I worked with a lot of like very professional, known people there.
And models and designers and the works.
Yeah, I thought you knew that. No,
no I didn't, genuinely. Yeah. I should start stalking people on Facebook.
Yeah. it was amazing.
Okay. And how, what did they say? I'm so proud of you to know that a Sri Lankan was there, like, nailing you with the big guns.
Yeah, I was actually the
youngest
only,
as well?
Probably the only South Asian who was in that
click. So were you called in after?
Yeah, they actually contacted me after I got back to Sri Lanka. So unfortunately, I was here. I couldn't like make it.
Okay.
So, but let's see, like, I'm in touch with them.
Excellent. That's great. Yeah. So what do you feel that's wrong about makeup in Sri Lanka? Do you think we kind of overdo it at times?
The thing is, you can't really have rules in terms of like any form of art, you can't have rules. But I always wanted to do something like natural, which brings out the person's features. So it's actually becoming a big trend now. When I first started, it wasn't like people didn't know about
like,
didn't.
Why are you applying nude colors all over me and thinking this makeup?
Yeah, but give now like young people, like young girls, they love that look. So it's actually like in my eyes, that's the best way of doing makeup. But that doesn't mean I don't like to like do glamorous makeup.
Yeah.
But the trick is to like still make it look natural, even if you put like a lot of makeup.
So in terms of social media, like you put up clients' pictures where before and after. Are they okay with that?
I asked them for permission.
Okay.
Yeah. I won't do that to others. Yeah.
See, no, others. Like some videos, like not you.
But I actually admire that confidence, and if you really talk to them, they are these ladies, these women who I put like before pictures of. They are naturally beautiful. That they are very confident.
Because if anyone says that, come on, we don't have dark circles, we don't have any of those, it's literally impossible. Then you have just been in a fridge all your life. Now, in terms of like Sri Lanka and migrating, would you be planning on setting your feet somewhere else? Because we see you in London so often that sometimes I wonder whether you're even here.
The thing is, what I like doing is more creative stuff, like fashion and editorial shoots. So fashion is not a, as you know, it's not a big thing here.
Of course.
So I like doing bridals. It's a big industry here, so financially it helps me, it supports me. But what I would like to do is like creative stuff. Mm. So that's why I want to like work somewhere else.
Those avant-garde makeup, like showstopper.
Yeah. That's why I've got to do some of my like the creative stuff in London.
So what you're studying in London, you always go, you put up all these close-up shots of models. Is that where you study?
I trained first 6 years. I learned everything on my own. Then I got a scholarship in one of the most privileged schools in London, makeup school. So that's where I trained to do makeup. So yeah, that was a very, very, very good opportunity.
Yeah. Well, that's great. Well, it's time that we say goodbye on the show. But before we go, I have to tell you, I've known Viran from the days that he used to be crony thin, small, with super long spiky hair, and we all look the same, no? We all had the same
cut. It was like the in hairstyle then.
Like, falling off branches. But it was so in. But from there to today, I was just telling him, it's just remarkable to see him. And also the fact that he's so grounded. You can talk to him at any time. All the people think he's snobby. She can be, actually.
No, I'm actually shy. I'm not.
But
he's, people actually think I'm uptight.
Yeah, you are. Like,
that's because I'm shy.
He's tied somewhere else.
Yeah, thankfully.
But we need to say goodbye. It has been amazing. Viran, thank you so very much for coming.
Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, amazing. I'm so happy. I can't wait to have you on more shows and see more of your work on Hi TV. We need to wrap things up for the whole season. Thank you so very much for being with us for the last 16 episodes. We have met and spoken and dined with some brilliant personalities from cricket to fashion to runway to business entrepreneurs. We have had them all. And that's what's amazing. And this show would have not been possible without a brilliant team that I have, who always support in making programming look phenomenal. So a big shout out to Charit, Naveksha, the team that has been making Down on Fire possible, and to the whole camera unit that has come and sweated, because this is just a fun part. There's a process that happens, no? And at the same time, to Hasaranga for all those brilliant photographs, and not forgetting LICC Jeans for those stunning sponsorship. And thanks for continuing. We'll see you with another brilliant episode next time around. I don't know where it's going to be, how it's going to be, but it's going to be different and it's going to be bigger. Viran, thank you so very much.
Thank you so much.
We shall see more of you. It's a wrap.